Okay, I'm going to answer a couple of the most common questions I get asked that are side effects that we might not want to see, but people don't know why they occur. So Jamie's going to ask, and we'll see if I know the answer.
What should you never do if you need a lip lift?
What should you never do if you need a lip lift? Lip lifts, a lot of people don't want to have surgical lip lifts. They don't want to have the scar, but the problem is the piriform aperture or the bone in the face, it widens, we lose bone and we get remodeling of the bone and the upper lip lengthens. So if you have a short upper lip, so a distance from the nose to the upper lip, then over time it's going to improve and lengthen. You're good. If it looks perfect, or the distance is long to begin with, as we age, it goes the wrong way. It lengthens. And so if you have a long distance here, from here to here is already long, and you are injecting this area, the depressor septi nasii muscle that's used to inject, if the tip is coming down, that's the other thing that happens as we age, or with a big smile, the tip comes down, then you're going to relax the lifting of the lip. And in turn, you're going to increase the length here. And if you do that and it's already long, meaning you might want a lip lift if that were to happen, then you're going to be unhappy with this injection. Even if it stopped the nose from coming down, you might not like the length. Let's go to a flip side of that. If you had a gummy smile, and you inject it, you'd be happy because you don't lift as much, and so you have more or less gum show, less teeth show. So that's why you might not want to inject the base of the nose if you need or want or desire a lip lift procedure. So if that's a question you like the answer to, or you didn't get the answer, join the AMIT virtual course. We cover those and much, much more, everything injectables.